Thank you. Good evening, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Let us include in our prayers the following intentions. For the thanksgiving of Water Market for their anniversary, Gabriel Galang Flores. For the birthday thanksgiving of Eric Dimabuyu, Rina Ocampo Alarcon, Nora Galang, Leonila Apong Leoning Ocampo, for her 80th birthday, Ersenia Bustos Sembrano, for her 80th birthday, Nancy Dorothy Bionzon, for her 50th birthday, Kian Jasper De Leon, Arnold R. Luciano, Jenny DeFonterum, for the special intentions of Phil and Janet Castro and family, for the good health and healing of Conching Galang Malonzo, Noel Torno, Ernesto Godoy Silva, Eduardo K. Galang Sr., Francia Damena Bansil, Ernesto Dizon, and all our sick relatives and friends, for the eternal repose of the souls of Joel Barden, Ralph Victor Nakpil, Marilu Diaz Abaya, Corazon Salvador Antonio, Hermogenes Milliard Tiopaco, Marilu Valerio Suriano, Lina Lansang, Monsignor Rustico Cuevas, Mary Joan Santiago, Raimundo and Patrocinia Salvador, Victor and Heather Salvador, Leila Peña for her 7th death anniversary, Castor P. Lacson Jr., Vicente Roque, Father Herwin Bulawan, Maria Teresa Morales, Dionisio Mandal, and all poor souls in purgatory. Let us all rise to glorify the Lord by singing the entrance hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, Pope.
Good evening, Father.
Let us offer our Mass with the intentions offered in our Mass, our also intention, our personal prayers, and also continue to seek, to ask, and to knock. Sometimes you want to give up. For many years, maybe, we've been knocking, we've been seeking our answers, and we've been looking. And yet, the grace of God and the miracles happen before those who are willing to wait, and those who have the faith in their hearts. For the times that we have sinned, we ask the Lord for pardon. Together we pray, I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. I invite you to remember your prayer intention, your petition, and the prayers of those whom you promised to pray for them. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The Liturgy of the Word.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Galatians. O stupid Galatians, who has bewitched you, before whose eyes Jesus Christ was publicly portrayed as crucified? I want to learn only this from you. Did you receive the Spirit from works of the law or from faith in what you heard? Are you so stupid? After beginning with the Spirit, are you now ending with the flesh? Did you experience so many things in vain? If indeed it was in vain, does then the one who supplies the Spirit to you and works mighty deeds among you do so from works of the law or from faith in what you heard? The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people.
This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, and all the days of our life.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people. Let us all rise to honor the Holy Gospel. Open our hearts, O Lord, to listen to the words of your Son.
Alleluia, alleluia, wikain mo, poon nakikinig ako sa iyo, mga salita, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, suppose one of you has a friend to whom he goes at midnight and says, friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived at my house from a journey, and I have nothing to offer him. And he says in reply from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children and I are already in bed. I cannot get up to give you anything. But I tell you, if he does not get up to give him the loaves because of their friendship, he will get up to give him whatever he needs, because of his persistence. And I tell you, ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds, and to the one who knocks the door will be opened. What father among you would have his son a snake when he asks for a fish? Or hand him a scorpion if he asks for an egg? If you then, you who are wicked, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to us who ask him? My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Do you know or do you have an idea how miracles happen? Paano po kaya nagkakaroon ng milagro? Or did you ever experience a miracle in your life? Or do you pray for a miracle? I myself, I also experience miracles or witness them in other people's lives as a priest. I'm not an expert when it comes to miracles, but maybe we could also define it. A miracle happens not from nothing. It's not nothing to something. It is usually based on something. It starts with something. May pinag-uumpisahan. Do you remember the first miracle of Jesus? The wedding at Cana? One of his miracles na sabi niya, it's not yet my time. And yet, Mama Mary persuaded him to transform water into wine. But the water did not come from nothing. The wine did not come from nothing. It started with water. Ang milagro, hindi po nag-umpisa sa wala. Dapat meron muna. Kahit tubig lang. Kahit simple lang. Kahit konti muna. Hindi tayo magkaroon ng milagro kung hindi tayo mag-umpisa kung anong meron tayo. Do you remember the feeding of the 5,000? Pinakain ni Jesus ang 5,000. Hindi naman nakaupo tapos itanaas ang kamay ni Kristo at kumain sila lahat. San po nag-umpisa yung pagpapakain ng 5,000? Nag-umpisa sa 5 tinapay at saka sa 2 isda. You have to start from somewhere. Baka naman naghihintay tayo ng milagro, naghihintay tayo ng himala, wala naman tayong ginawa. Wala tayong pinag-uumpisahan. I tell you, God gave you something. God gave you already what it takes to experience more miracles in our lives. Kaya nga, yung effort mo dito to ask, to seek, and to knock, these are expressions of you start with something as your effort. Sabi nga ng mga kabataan ngayon, mag-effort ka naman. Minsan mayroon akong kilala, nagpapatulong siya sa isang opisina na may kilala ako, na dati rin ako doon. Nagpapatulong siya, he was very persistent naman, according to the gospel. Nagpapatulong siya, I think it's about an application for a job. No? Nag-apply siya sa isang trabaho. Gusto niya, bigyan ko siya ng recommendation. No? Actually, I could also help him, lalo na nung nandun ako sa many years ago sa San Fernando. I could help him. E di, gumawa na ako na sulat, no? And naging kaklase ko yung director dun sa department na yon. And when I was working on the paper, my recommendation, natanong ko sa kanya, kailan mo sinubmit yung application letter mo? No? Para I could mention na last week, my friend offered to apply in your office for this concern. Ngayon, sumagot yung kaibigan ko, yung nagpapatulong. Sabi niya, ay Father, hindi pa ako nag-apply. No? Hindi pa ako nag-apply. How can a miracle happen if you do not yet apply? No? Paano kang matatanggap sa trabaho kung di ka naman naghahanap ng trabaho, kung di ka naman nag-apply? If you do not give your share, it starts with something. A miracle starts with something. Even a big tree starts with a seed or a seedling or a twig. Kailangan mag-umpisa tayo. Anong meron tayo? Ikalawa, miracles happen when there's persistence. The persistence that you do not easily give up. To ask persistently, to knock persistently, and to seek persistently. The key word in the gospel, yung tiyaga, yung hindi kagad sumusuko. Baka naman sabihin mo, I already asked. I was already seeking. I already knocked. Baka naman kumatok ka lang, ganyan. Isa lang. Baka naman kaya hindi narinig. O kaya hindi napansin. Nung kumakatok ka, hindi naman alam. Because the desire in our hearts should be fervent enough not to give up easily. Marami kagad sumusuko. Marami kagad umaayaw. Pwede ito sa trabaho. Pwede ito sa relasyon. Pwede din po ito sa swerte. Alam niyo po, mga taong nagiging matagumpay,
hindi naman yung pinakamagaling sa klase yung taong nagiging matagumpay, hindi naman yung pinakamatas yung grade o kaya pinakamagaling yung mga magulang, karamihan yung nagiging matagumpay, yung matyaga. Matyagang maghintay, maghanap, kumatok, at humingi sa Diyos. When we ask God, though we know God already knows, the desire in our hearts is more emphasized. Parang yung expression, this great palace was built from one brick to another, from one stone to another stone. Hindi po kagad nangyayari. And we do not easily give up. We do not easily let go. And we do not easily surrender. Nung nag-aaral po kami sa seminaryo, lalo na nung theology, nasa theology po kami, meron kaming klase, ang title ng aming klase, Grace. 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 At sabi nung professor namin, grace works through human nature. No? Ang grasya ng Diyos ay dumadaan sa ating pagkatao. Gusto mo nang magkaroon ng tinapay? Hindi man ho talaga nahuhulog yung tinapay galing sa langit. Kamukha ng dating nababasa natin sa Biblia, kagad na lang nahulog yung lang. O bigla na lang dumating yung maraming isda sa yung basket o napuno ng pagkain ang yung refrigerator. God's grace works through human nature. You can participate in that miracle through our human capacity. To a person who help you, can you become an instrument of this wonderful miracle? Start with something and be persistent. Kumisan tawag dyan, devotion. Kumisan ang tawag sa panalangin na yan, panata. Kumisan ang tawag sa panalangin na yan, our persistent hope and intention. I remember Santa Monica who was praying for her son, Augustine, and her many years of pain and tears, even praying for her husband. And when his son, her son, converted, he did not only become a Catholic or a Christian, even became a doctor of the church, and became a bishop of Hippo, and became a saint. Even the founder of the Augustinian community. Persistence. Lastly, we have to qualify. Miracles are not magic. Magic are tricks. May pinapanood mo sa YouTube yung paano nagmamagic yung mga magician. Usually, they have a trick. Tama ho ba yun? Yung walang rabbit, biglang magkakaroon ng rabbit. Yung pigeon, magiging marami. O yung bola, biglang mawawala. Instant magic. Maybe we are looking for magic, kaya hindi natin makita. Maybe kala natin, pag binagdasal natin, bukas nandito na. O ginusto natin, kumatok at nabuksan na. Remember that miracles are not a trick, are not tricks from God. We have to know that we do not give up easily because magic are instant. They are there to entertain you. But miracles are deeper, with sense of patience and faith, hope, and a reason for us not to give up on one another and our faith for others and our prayer for our own needs. Alam niyo po si Thomas Edison. Si Edison, siya po yung naka-invento ng light bulb. Hanggang ngayon, ginagamit natin. Sa mga bahay natin, usually, yun tayong light bulb. How many times did Thomas Edison try before Eureka, the discovery came? Once, twice, 100 times, 200 times, 300, 500, more than 1,000 times. He failed. Ilang beses pumutok yung bulb sa harap ng mukha niya. Siguro, mayroong time na nakuryente siya, nasugat siya, nashock siya. And then when he discovered, finally, the bulb, the light is already there. Tinanong siya, "How many times did you fail?" Tapos sagot niya, "I did not fail. I only discovered how not to do it. So I was led to the right answer." Every mistake, he did not give up. Every mistake, he did not blame anybody. Or he said, "Hanggang dito na lang ako." But every mistake, he said, is closer to the right answer. Miracles are not magic. The miracle of the bulb, every time we see it, always remember somebody really worked hard for it, for us to have lights at home. Minsan po, mayroon isang lalaki, payatot lang, payatot. Gusto niya maging malakas siya. Gusto niya maging matipuno siya. Kaya nagpunta po doon isang hermitanyo, master na nasa bundok, para maging siyang malakas. Nagihingi siya ng advice for him to be strong and to be able to lift more things, no? Maging matipuno siya and to be healthier in a sense. So pumunta siya sa kanyang naririnig niya may ermitanyo doon, magaling siya, ituturo kung anong tanong mo. Kung may nahanap ka, bibigay niya sa'yo. Sige, sabi niya, punta ako doon, baka magkakaroon ng bigla ako lalakas, no? Siguro may papainom na magic o kaya papakain. Baka may sikreto yon. Pumunta po siya, dinatnya niya yung ermitanyo, nagdarasal. And after praying, naghintay naman yung lalaki, sabi, "Master, can you teach me how to be strong? Gusto kong maging malakas." Tumingin yung master, "Pwedeng bumalik ka na lang bukas. Mayroon pa akong gagawin. No, walang appointment." "Opo, master, I will come back tomorrow." Tapos nung pababa na siya sa bundok, sabi nung master, "Can you bring the cow?" "Mayroon akong baka, bagong silang. Kasi silang parang kahapon. Pero dito, no, may maliit lang siya, yung mami niya. Can you bring it down, no? Para makakain siya. Namatay kasing nanay niya. Baka may gatas doon sa baba. And then, dala nyo lang bukas. At saka, pag tuturo na lang kita pag may time ako." So, bumaba yung lalaki, dala-dala niya yung baka. Malit lang naman eh. Siguro, mga doon, no? Ilang kilos lang. Binaba niya sa bundok. The next day, dala-dala na naman yung baka, na very, very young. Binalik niya doon sa master. Binaba niya, "Master, can you teach me how to be strong?" Sabi ng master, "May kausap ako ng ibang tao. Pwedeng bumalik ka na lang bukas. Idala mo itong baka, no? At tsaka na lang kita tuturuan." The third day, bumalik siya, dala-dala niya yung baka, nagpapaturo siyang maging malakas, hindi siya nagkakaroon ng oras sa kanyang master. Hanggang araw-araw, nagbabalik siya, dinadala niya yung baka, kasi sa bundok, nung medyo ano, walang grass, walang damon, kung pinapakain doon sa plain. So araw-araw, kasama niya yung baka, binubuhat niya, papunta sa bundok. After a long, long time, pagkatapos ng matagal na panahon, hindi siya kinakausap nung ermitanyo. Hindi naman niya tinuturo paano maging malakas. Nung medyo matagal-tagal na rin, nagalit na itong very patient man. Sabi niya, "Master, I've been going to you every day. I've been asking you every day to make me strong. But you never did anything. You never helped me how to be strong. You never taught me. You never trained me how to be strong. You always ask me to go back here every day. I'm waiting to teach me. Tapos tinignan siya ng ermitanyo. "How can you say you are not strong? Tignan mo nga yung bakang binubuhat mo araw-araw. From a baby calf, no? Now he's already full-blown. Ang laki-laki na ng baka, binubuhat niya pa araw-araw. And he did not realize how strong he was from the everyday experience of carrying that animal upon his shoulders. Miracles happen, my dear friends. It starts with something. It also proceeds with the persistence of our everyday efforts. And when we are willing not to give up and willing to wait, indeed, miracles are not magic. They unfold before us. And I believe for those who knock, for those who seek, to those who ask, the answer, the door, and what you're looking for will be there. Wait for that miracle to happen. May God bless us all. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Please stand.
Christ makes a promise, ask and it will be given to you. Let us come to our Heavenly Father with trust and confidence. We pray, loving Father, we await all from you.
Loving Father, we await all from you. That as a church, we may be committed to a sincere and deep life of prayer, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, we await all from you.
That active people may learn to integrate prayer in their work, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, we await all from you.
That we may persist in prayer, no matter how discouraged we may be by life's misfortunes, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, we await all from you.
That the sick may unite their prayers and sacrifices with Christ's suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, we await all from you.
That the faithful departed may be raised up with Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Father, we await all from you.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions.
Almighty God, you are generous beyond all our imagination in ways we do not understand. Hear the prayers we make. Through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The Liturgy of the Eucharist.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this bread we offer, fruit of the earth, work of our hands, it will become the bread of life. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen.
Pray, my dear friends, that this sacrifice may be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries we have celebrated with dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work which you have pleased to redeem us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which shall be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Florentino, our Bishop, and all the priests and all our friends who work and serve you in our church, in our community here at Holy Cross. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Yes.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The love and peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Those who have persistence, tiyaga. And those who are willing to wait, patience. And to all start with whatever we have, I think a miracle is along the way. Let us have this faith, our hope, and this sense of peace in our hearts. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us share with one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Oratio Imperata. God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant this, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael, the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be replenished and nourished by this sacrament which have received us to be transformed into what we consume. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God rest upon you and upon your family and loved ones, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is offered. Let us knock, let us seek, and let us ask, and miracles will happen. Thanks be to God.